you tune in to the Zaki Vika Show. And as usual, we are uplifting and empowering the community. We want you to share your story. So get in touch with us via Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, or YouTube. Drop it down, VK. From Lab Productions, and we're right here at the Erasmia Palms Boutique Hotel and Spa, and we have the gentleman himself, Chief Mandla Mandela. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah so much for giving me 5 minutes of your time. So I just have a few questions. So Chief, people may argue that heritage has become that warm fuzzy blanket that we used to reminisce about the past, when in fact it is actually about the struggle. What is your thoughts about that?
Well, our heritage for us has always been about our very own experiences of the past, the lessons we've learned from there, and how we can utilize those experiences and lessons of the past to fully understand the present. Mm-hmm. And how we can utilize that to better plot and see a way forward for the future. And I think today it is very important for the elders and the current generation to be able to educate our young people about our heritage and our past experiences, so that they can be fully cognizant of the challenges we are facing today. But most importantly, to secure a better future for themselves.
Very good answer. Absolutely. Because I would say, what is more important? Is heritage more important or a brighter future more important? But the way you're explaining is it has to be interlinked.
It is interlinked. One shapes our own understanding of the present, if you're speaking about our heritage. Mm-hmm. And in order to have a successful meaning of trying to plot a vision for the future, you fully have to understand and draw lessons from those past experiences. And for us in the family I come from, and the work that forefathers of our family have fought against colonialism, fought against land disposition, my grandfather getting into politics and fighting against the apartheid regime, those are lessons that we cherish as a family and we draw from to understand the current dynamics we are facing, and also to understand as to what would be the solutions in creating a better future for younger generations.
Absolutely. Chief, one of Dada's favorite quotes was to look after our children, that it is our responsibility to take care of our children because they are our future. Are we doing justice? The mere incident yesterday about the 4 youngsters that got abducted, are we doing justice?
We haven't done enough in terms of ensuring the safety of our children. And I think government has tried to bring about early childhood development centers, and the social Department of Social Development has enabled every child to be able to have a full meal at school. But I think there's much more that needs to be done, particularly around parenting. In our travels with my wife, we often see young children as young as 3 years, 4 years walking on their own great distances. And in the country that we are living in with gender-based violence, particularly targeting young children, where they disappear and they are totally violated, we need to do a lot more in protecting our young people. And it's a really saddening and shocking thing to wake up to the 4 abducted brothers of the Moti brothers.
Yes.
That have been abducted. And we want to make a special call to the safety and security cluster, the South African Police Services, to do all in their means in ensuring they leave no stone unturned in finding these young children.
Um, Your statement regarding the boycotting of the Miss World to be held in Israel in December, do you think our current Miss South Africa is going to, Lalela, is she going to stand by the decision? Is she going to support your decision?
We must be very clear as South Africans. We are very proud of all our Miss South Africans.
Absolutely.
They've done very stunning work.
Absolutely.
And we congratulated our Miss South Africa, Lalela Mswane. She's an excellent Miss South Africa. She was very dynamic during the contest. She spoke boldly. Particularly with women issues and children issues. But also come to learn during the Miss South Africa contest that the next Miss Universe would be held in apartheid Israel. And we as activists on the ground, understanding that Israel is an apartheid state, have become vocal to say, Lalela, you represent and you are a face for women, not only in South Africa, but women across the continent and across the globe. Yes. And women in Palestine are suffering a real brutality under an oppressive regime. You find a lot of young women and children lingering in apartheid Israeli jails. You can make a difference. We only, as South Africans, asking you to walk out, following the footsteps of Miss Malaysia, Miss Indonesia, and of late, Miss Greece has supported the call to boycott Miss Universe being held in apartheid Israel. And we must make this clear, we don't have anything against Miss World and Steve Harvey. Some of us grew up watching the Steve Harvey show. And therefore, the issue we have is the location that Miss World is being held. It is in an apartheid state that is carrying out heinous killings against Palestinians. And we will not stop until the message receives full attention from locally at Miss South Africa, but we are also calling on all African participants in particular who have found themselves in the African Union, where the chairperson of the African Union has unilaterally granted an observer status to Israel. We are saying to African participants at Mr. Universe, you can retract and send a strong message to the AU that they must withdraw the observer status that has been accorded to apartheid Israel. We cannot be comfortable and normalize the state of Israel.
Definitely. I truly agree with it. And it would be a loud and bold statement to all women across the world. Last question, Chief. We all love our parents, I think more our grandparents, more so than our parents. And for obvious reasons, we know why we love our grandparents more. If you had to criticize some decision, and with the utmost respect, one of Tata's decisions that he made, what would you do different?
There's nothing else. My grandfather has not only been a mentor to me, but a true mentor and an idol. Adiba and myself were introduced while I was a 2-month-old baby at Robben Island, which I have no recollection of that. My father and my mother have told me repeatedly these stories.
Right.
But I will always cherish the first time I met Adiba when I was 9 years old in Portsmouth Prison.
Okay, is that when you remember him?
Yes.
Yes.
And it left a lasting memory within me. And sitting by his side over the years, while he was still in prison and in Victor Verster prison, I was afforded an opportunity to visit him and spend a weekend with him. And when he was released, and to sit and watch him navigate and guide us through the most difficult times of our transition into democracy, and to see him being afforded the opportunity to lead us as a country, as the founding father of our nascent democracy, has been a true learning experience for me. And I've continuously looked with amazement as to how he's been able to guide us in the spirit of nation building, national reconciliation, and ensuring that we are able as South Africans to put our country first. And it is those memories that I will forever cherish, but also his continuously being present at protecting the rights of minorities has always been a remarkable thing that I will always cherish. So I've not found myself finding the wrongs or things that I would change in him, but I think his maker is the only one that would be able to find the wrongs and the challenges that Madiba faced in life. For me, I will always remember him as the grandfather that bought me my first pair of soccer boots.
Wow! I can hear a croak in your voice. I too have a croak in my voice now. But on behalf of the community of Mariam, I must say that he did an excellent job. And thank you so much for being here with us and honoring us. And with you yourself, he's did an excellent job, and you've learned great lessons from him. Thank you, Chief. We really appreciate your presence.
Shukran for everything. We've enjoyed our stay in Lodium. And my wife has promised to drag me back here, particularly to come and visit our family that is out here, because we were seeing them for the first time after a very long time. So we are certain that we'll be back in the near future, inshallah.
Inshallah, ameen. And it will only be an honor to have you and your wife back. Yeah. Jazakallah so much.
Thank you.